Woohoo! We are here this morning because I've had my coffee and students have been asking me, how do I graph a parabola? This is so frustrating. And I'm here to say it is absolutely frustrating, but let me show you a few helpful hints that hopefully will make it slightly less frustrating. So we are here in section 8.4. This is for Math 60, but this applies to all of WebAssign's various graphing problems. WebAssign has the same graphing interface for all levels. So hopefully this is helpful for everyone. In this problem, I'm asked to graph three different functions. Now, since they all have x squared, they are all parabolas. Pardon me. Now, so in order to graph them, I'm going to graph them one at a time. I'm going to start with f of x is x squared. And because it's a parabola, I'm going to come down here to the parabola key. See how it's a parabola? Now, if you click on this little arrow down here, you'll see you have two options. This is a parabola that opens upward. In other words, it's got a vertical axis of symmetry. And so I'm going to use this one, the one that looks like a smile. So I'm going to go ahead and click on it. Now you have to make sure you've got this in blue, dark blue or dark colored, so that it knows to graph a parabola. Now, WebAssign only wants 2 points. So you should generally start with the axis, or sorry, the vertex. So we're going to start with the vertex. F of x equals x squared. I'm going to start with the point 0, 0, since it goes through the point 0, 0. And you can see it gives you that little tiny 0, 0 there. And then I happen to know that this also goes through the point 1, 1. If I click 1, 1, suddenly I've got the whole parabola. And notice that I've got vertical parabola 1 written here. If I click on this arrow over here, I can see there are my 2 points, 0, 0, 1, 1. Life is good. Okay, now I'm gonna go to the second parabola. In this case, I've got g of x equals 6x squared. Now this one also goes through 0, 0. So I'm gonna come through, I'm gonna double click here. So again, I've got the parabola. I have to reset the parabola tool each single time. I'm going to click on 0, 0, and then I'm going to click on the point 1, 6. Don't panic. And then I panic. Oh no, I clicked on the point 1, 7. I meant to click on the point 1, 6. Oh no, oh no, what will I do? Well, what you do is, instead of trying to wiggle this thing, because let me guarantee you, I've tried that many times, I'm just gonna come in here to my second parabola and I'm gonna see, okay, I've got the point 0, 0, but I've got the point 1, 7. I want the point when x is 1, I get 1 squared, which is 1 times 6 is 6. So I'm gonna come in here and I'm going to manually change that value. You'll notice the point moves down on the graph and I've got the correct graph here. Yay! Okay, so I'm gonna close this one. And then the last one, 1/6 x squared. I know that it's a parabola. So I have to go back into the parabola tool, double click. I know that its vertex is at 0, 0. But now my other point is, ugh, when x is 1, y is 1/6. I can't even graph this. So for my second point, I'm just going to pick a random point anywhere on the graph. Seriously, anywhere on the graph, just plot a second point. And then I'm going to go in here and I'm going to fix this. I've got 1. And then I think, can I plug it in as 1/6? Yes, it's accepting it as, see how I wrote it as a fraction. Now, if you write it as a decimal, I believe WebAssign will not accept it because it's not the actual value. So you need to write it as the fraction. Fingers crossed, I'm gonna submit the answer. Waiting to hear. I did it, we did it, we did it together. So again, for parabolas, remember to double click on the parabola tool, make sure it's the correct parabola, not the sideways parabola, unless you're graphing a sideways parabola. And then remember, each parabola requires 2 points, and you can always come in over here and you can type them in. So you can click any 2 points you want and go ahead and fix the values here. And then remember that unless the fraction is a nice fraction, like 1/2 is 0.5, 1/4 is 0.25, exactly. Unless the fraction is nice, if the fraction is something like 1/6, which is just nastiness, you can't enter it as a decimal. You need to write it as the fraction. And that's how you get it graphed. Woohoo! Hopefully this has been helpful. Hopefully you're going to be like, yay, now I can do all my homework and life is great. And then you can go, you know, get some sunshine and some exercise and maybe even some vegetables. Woohoo, vegetables. And know that you guys are awesome. And I think you're amazing. And math on.